सुक्तिजा, आई एम वर्किंग एज ए असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन फूड टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट इन विज्ञान फाउंडेशन फॉर साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट. टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट ऑन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ जियोस्पेस बेवरेजेस. सो लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन. सो जूस एंड जूस प्रोडक्ट्स रिप्रेजेंट्स द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सेगमेंट्स इन ऑल द टोटल फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री. Juice products are being marketed as refrigerated, shelf-stable and frozen in varying packaging with increasing emphasis on functionality, health attributes and also as well as in some cases it is fortified with vitamins and minerals. So high quality juice operations are depend upon high quality of raw material which we are using. So most fruit juices are excellent sources of vitamin C, carotene, and also it is contain moderate amount of pyridoxin, inositol, folic acid and biotin. And also the fruit juices are rich sources of energy since it is rich in carbohydrate. And the organic acid which is present in a fruit juice helps to maintain acid and base in our body. It helps to maintain the acid and base in our body. So let us discuss about the general processing step of juice. So the first important step is selection of fruit. Okay, so select a fruit which is in sound. Okay, so when we are discussing about the processing of juice, the process starts with the selection of fruit. Okay, so the fruit was selected freshly from harvested tree or taken from refrigerated or frozen storage. How usually fruit were selected. Okay, so once the fruit was selected, then the selected fruit was subjected for cleaning and washing. Okay, so cleaning and washing is a process where it removes the dirt and foreign objects from the fruit, followed by sanitation. In order to decrease the microbial load, sanitation process is followed. So often proper cleaning and washing, the next step is sorting. So sorting is a very important step in order to maintain the quality of juice. So in order to maintain the final quality of juice, the sorting process is very important. So usually in sorting process, the high decay or moldy fruits were removed. This step is necessary in order to ensure a high quality juice in the final product. So after doing sorting, then the sorted fruit was subjected for peeling and pulping. So this step will be optional for various fruits. Usually for mango, we are doing a pulping to extract the juice. So prior to extracting the juice, so the pulping process is carried out for mango. Okay, for usually strawberry, pineapple, guava, for all this the pulping is required prior to juice extraction. Okay, so after pulping, then the next steps is juice extraction, where we are subjecting this pulp or peeled fruit for juice extraction. So after the extracting the juice from the pulp, so the next the extracted juice containing a suspended solids, it requires a treatment. Okay, so it's all depending upon the characteristics of final product. If you want to prepare a cloudy juice, so usually for cloudy juice, the depectinization is not required. Okay, for manufacturing of cloudy juice, coarse centrifugation is enough to remove the large insoluble suspended solids. Okay. But in case of clarified juice, for clarified juice, complete depectinization is required and high speed centrifugation is also required in order to make juice clear. So after doing centrifugation, then the juice was subjected for filtration, okay, in order to make juice clear. So after this, the juice was subjected for heat treatment. So why heat treatment means? In order to kill or inhibit the microorganisms and also to extend the shelf life of the product. Usually pasteurization will be carried out for all fruit juice industry in order to increasing the shelf life of the product. So after pasteurization, then they were subjected this for filling and bottling. So let us discuss in depth about on the processing of juice. Okay, usually the process will start with the selection of fruit. So in previous slide, I already discussed about this selection of fruit. So how we are selecting a fruit means, usually the fruits were taken from a freshly harvested field or taken from the refrigerated or frozen storage. So after selecting a fruit, okay, so then we are subjecting that for cleaning and washing purpose. Okay, so one important thing during the selection of fruit is select a undamaged or uninjured fruits. Okay, the selected fruit should be undamaged or undecayed. Okay, and remove the fruit which shows moldy and underripened. Otherwise, this underripened fruit will be rich in pectin. It makes the juice haziness. Okay, it will look like cloudy appearance. So after selecting a fruit, so the next step is cleaning and washing. So in cleaning and washing, what will happen usually? During cleaning and washing, the adhering dirt or soil and some foreign objects will be removed. Okay, so in washing purpose, usually they were using a chlorine and also they were using sometimes detergents in order to remove the stubborn soil, and sometimes they were using a warm water. So why they were using a warm water means, in order to remove the waxes. Usually fruits were coated with waxes. So in order to remove the waxes, the warm temperature is required. Usually at 50 degrees Celsius, they were using a water for cleaning purpose, followed by sanitation in order to decrease the microbial load. So after cleaning and washing, the next step is sorting. So sorting is a very important step because our final product will depend upon the sorting process, because it ensures the high quality in the final juice. So we can clearly see from this picture, okay, the roller bar which is horizontally drawn by the chains, okay, it moves the mango forward and rotates at the same time. Okay, during this process, the staff members were inspecting the incoming mangoes in all the handles and they were picked out the unqualified mangoes. Okay, so after sorting, then again they were subjecting this for peeling and pulping. So peeling and pulping process will be depend upon the type of fruit which we are used for the preparation of the juices. Okay, so here we can clearly see here from the picture, this is the pulping machine. Okay, so where we are subjecting the mango for pulping. Okay, so here the mango separated the skin and it removes the stone separately. So if you are done peeling and pulping prior to juice extraction, it makes the extraction of juice efficiently.
So after this, the next main step is fruit juice extraction. So coming to the fruit juice extraction, the extraction of juice, whatever the equipment they were used for extracting the juice will be varied. It depends upon the type of fruits they were subjected for extracting the juices. Okay, so in this picture we are clearly seeing that the hand roller was used for pressing the juice from oranges. Okay, so fruit juices extraction will require a more technological steps. So it comprises crushing, juice separation from solid fruit fresh particles, or juice treatment and preparation for filling. So then after that, for example, melon and papaya, they were steamed in order to extract the juice. So it will depending upon the varying upon the type of fruit which were used. Okay, in case of apple, for extracting juice, usually they were subjecting for pressing. And in case of mango, guava, pineapple and strawberry, they were doing a pulping prior to juice extraction. During this process, care has to be taken because this juice, when it exposed to air for prolonged period, okay, so in the final product, it may cause browning or discoloration of the juices. So after extracting the juices, the next step is juice clarification. Since the extracted juice containing a suspended solids in it, so it makes juice cloudy in appearance. So in order to achieve visibility in juices, the clarification step is carried out. Okay, so usually the clarification process is required by means in order to achieve clarity. Okay, so the reason for cloudiness in juice is due to the fibers, cellulose, hemicellulose, propectin, starch and lipids. So these are all the materials which make juices cloudy in appearance. Okay, so in order to remove this, some of the clarification steps were carried out. The first one is by sedimentation process. So sedimentation is a very simple method, okay, where we are allowing the juices to settle down for a prolonged period. Means we are storing a juices for prolonged period so that the suspended solid particles get settled down in the bottom of the bottle. So after that, we are subjecting that for filtration purpose. Okay, so it's a very simple method. Next one is by use of fining agent. So fining agents are added in order to achieve visibility in the fruit juices. So fining agent may be physical or chemical fining agents, and sometimes enzymes were also used as a fining agent. Okay, coming to the physical fining agent. So in physical fining agent, diatomaceous earth and bentonite or china clay, this were used as a physical cleaning agent. Okay, in a physical fining agent, after adding this diatomaceous earth, usually this will be added in a fruit juice in the range of 0.5% to 1%. Okay, so after adding this, they were allowing the suspended solids to settle down, and after that they were passing for filtration. Okay, so this we call as a physical fining agent. So the next clarification is clarification by using chemical fining agents. So example for chemical fining agent is gelatin, casein, and we can use tannin and albumin. So this were used as a fining agent in fruit juices. Okay, so after adding this fining agent, colloidal substances carrying out the negative charges and precipitated when charges neutralized. So this is the exact mechanism of fining agent. So the next one is enzymes.
pectinase, arabinase, proteolytic pectin decomposing, etc. Okay, so some of the enzymes are used in order to remove this suspended solids. For example, take it an example, proteinase. So, or pectinase. Because why the juice is looking cloudy in appearance? Because of presence of protein, pectin, lipids, starch. This will make looks like a juice cloudy in appearance. Okay, so the addition of pectinase will make pectin free in the juices. So after adding pectinase in the juices, it makes the pectin free. Okay, so what will happen? The free pectin will get settled in the bottom. Okay, so then the clear juice were subjected for filtration purpose. So this is how we are achieving a visibility in the fruit juices by using the enzymes pectinase. So the reason for cloudiness in the fruit juices is because of pectin. So if you are using a unmatured fruit, okay, since the unmatured fruit is rich in pectin, it imparts cloudiness in the juices. So the next one is clarification by freezing. So this is also a very simple method, but it took too much of time because after preparing a juice, usually they were keeping at a temperature of -2 to -3 degrees Celsius in a refrigerated room. Okay, so after a 1 month of period, then they were subjecting this juice for clarification purpose. Okay, it's a very simple method, but disadvantage is here, so whatever the duration which is required for clarification is very long. The next clarification process is clarification by heating. So when we are eating a fruit juices, okay, so the suspended colloidal suspension get precipitated. Okay, so if you are allowing this for cooling, okay, so this particle will get settled down, and after that pass this for a filtration purpose, then we will get a visible clear juice. Usually clarification by heating was carried out for pomegranate juice. Okay, clarification by cooling was done for grape juices. So usually for all pomegranate juices, the clarification process will be achieved by heating process. Usually they were heating a pomegranate juice at a temperature of 75 to 80 degrees Celsius for few minutes, and they were suddenly cooling down this juice. Okay, and after that they were passing this for a filtration process. So then finally we will get a visible clear juice. So this is all about the clarification of juices. So next one is further processing of the prepared juice. So we in the previous slides we already discussed about the selection of the fruit, cleaning and washing. So after washing the fruit, then we are subjecting for sorting purpose. So then after sorting the fruit, okay, then the selected fruit were subjected for peeling and pulping prior to juice extraction. So once the juice extracted from the fruit, then we are subjecting that for clarification process. Okay, so once the step got finished, then if you wanted to preserve the juice, okay, if you wanted to increase the shelf life of the product, okay, we have a other alternative method way we can keep our product for long period. Okay, so the first one is evaporation, next one is concentration by freezing, and reverse osmosis, fruit concentrate storage. So in all this method, okay, what will happen means usually it will reduces the moisture content in the juice so that it concentrate the product. Since the moisture
is not available for microorganisms to grow. Okay, so therefore finally we can increase the shelf life of the product. For this we can use the evaporation, where it will reduce the, it removes the moisture. Okay, and we can use the concentration by freezing. This is the best method. In this we can preserve the flavor and color and some heat sensitive vitamins. The next one is reverse osmosis. Okay, in this again we can preserve the flavor and color. We can retain this and we can remove the microorganism also. Fruit concentrate storage. Okay, so we can store this product for a prolonged period. So if you wanted to use, then we can take this product and we can dilute and we can use. Okay, so this is all about the some of the processing method where we can use this for in the future. So the next one is preservation of the fruit juice. Once clarification process has done, okay, so everything has done, okay, the next step is to, we have to preserve the fruit juices. So usually preservation of fruit juices is carried out by various method, but in general in all the juice processing industry, pasteurization is one of the method where commonly they were following. Okay, pasteurization of fruit juices is usually carried out at a temperature of above 100 degree Celsius or slightly below 100 degree Celsius. So why pasteurization is carried out means, in order to kill the or inhibit the microorganisms. Pasteurization is carried out to kill or inhibit the microorganisms. Usually the pasteurization time will vary. Okay, it might be varying from 30 seconds to 30 minutes. So after doing it, pasteurization can be done by various methods, that is by using LTLT or HTST or even UHT. So these are all the methods of pasteurization where we can use. Okay, in general the HTST were used. This were also called as flash pasteurization. So the main advantage of flash pasteurization is we can retain the color and flavor. Also, so we can protect our product from loss of color and flavor, and also it retains the vitamins. Okay, it retains the vitamins. Some of the heat sensitive vitamins might be retained in flash pasteurization. Usually this is carried out at a temperature of minus 5.5 degrees Celsius for 1 minute. It is less than the actual pasteurization temperature. And pasteurization can also be done for bottle. So bottle pasteurization, we can clearly see from this picture where the exact bottle pasteurization was carried out. Okay, so usually after filling the juices into a bottle, then they were subjecting for pasteurization. Okay, so where they were keeping a bottle in a water bath, and usually pasteurization will be carried out at a temperature of 80 degrees Celsius. Okay, the duration will be varied. It's depending upon the size or volume of container which the bottle which we are subjected for pasteurization. Okay, so the next is, during the pasteurization, so what will happen, here in this picture we can clearly see that the bottle was subjected for pasteurization. Okay, so when we're keeping all the bottles in the pasteurization, in one of the bottle they were inserting a thermometer in order to check the whether the desired temperature is reached or not. This will be considered as a test bottle for checking the
temperature. In order to maintain the temperature inside the bottle, so in among the all the batches, in one of the bottle they were inserting a thermometer, so in order to check whether the desired temperature is reached or not. So after this, in bottle pasteurization there might be a benefit also and some of the problem will also there. So I already told you the in bottle pasteurization we are usually inserting a thermometer inside the bottle. Okay, so we can't predict the whether the desired temperature is reached or not in some of the bottles. Okay, and one more problem is usually for doing bottle pasteurization the material which is required will be the glass bottle only. So this is the main disadvantage. So coming to the benefits, okay, so the juice pasteurized within the bottle, okay, in this there will be a chances of recontamination of one of the juices reduced. So okay, so the recontamination is reduced in the case of bottle pasteurization, and also there is no need of using stainless steel for doing a pasteurization. So this is the benefit of doing bottle pasteurization. So next method is preservation by using a chemicals. Okay, for bulk quantity usually the preservation will be carried out by using a chemicals. So these are all the few chemicals which were required for preserving the chemicals. Okay, the first one is sulfates or sulfur dioxide. So sulfates or sulfur dioxide will be used in a juice as a preservative and the permitted level is 0.05 to 0.2%. Okay, so the addition of sulfur dioxide will suppress the growth of molds and bacteria. Okay, and the one important thing we have to keep in mind is sulfur dioxide usage will cause a discoloration in fruit juices. So if the juice is naturally colored, if juice the fruit itself giving a natural color to the juices, so after addition of this sulfur dioxide into the juices it may cause discoloration. Okay, next preservative is sorbic acid. So the sorbic acid will suppress the growth of molds and yeast. Usually this sorbic acid will be added at a rate of 0.05% to 0.2%. The next preservative, chemical preservative is benzoic acid. So the benzoic acid, again, it is naturally occurring cranberries, cinnamon and cloves. Okay, and this benzoic acid is well suited for acid fruit juices. Okay, and this benzoic acid will be added at a level of 0.03 to 0.2%. Usually it suppresses the bacteria especially. The next one is citric acid. Usually the citric acid were widely used in carbonated beverages, and the addition of citric acid not having any permitted level, we can freely use this citric acid. Okay, usually in carbonated beverages, citric acid were used as a acidulant. Okay, in all fruit-based carbonated beverages, the citric acid were used as a flavoring agent. And sometimes, not only it acts as acidulant, it also acts as a preservative in carbonated drinks. So these are all the chemicals way which were used for the preservation of fruit juices. So other methods were also available for preserving a juices. Not only this, preservation by heat or preservation by chemicals, we can preserve the juice by application of emerging technology like HPP or pulse electric field, homemade heating. So these are all the emerging technology where we can preserve the fruit juices, and even in order to retain the flavor or color or vitamins, and without any heat treatment, if you wanted to remove the microbial load from the fruit juices, we can follow ultrafiltration filtration process where it removes the microorganisms.
Okay, so these are all the preservation methods. The next one is, after adding a preservative or after giving a proper heat treatment, the next step is you are subjecting the treated juices for filling and bottling.
Okay, so before filling the juices into the bottles, the thorough washing is required, or in bottle sterilization will be carried out.
Okay, so then aseptically drawn the fruit juices into the bottles, but care has to taken. Okay, fill the juices up to a level of 1.2 to 2.5 centimeter head space has to leave when we are filling the fruit juices into bottles. So after that, so if you are carrying out a heat treatment in bottles, okay, then for sealing of caps, usually crown corks were used. Okay, in case if you are doing a filling a chemically treated juices, then for sealing of cap, usually we are using a filter proof caps.
So the next one is, I am showing a video, so how the filling and bottling were carried out.
So these are all the cans where they were subjecting for sterilization process.
Okay,
so where they were passing this cans, the sterilized cans, the sterilized treated can were subjected for filling of juices. See in this picture. So after sterilized, then the cans were subjecting for filling of juices. It's a continuous process. See here. So after this, it will be continuous process where they were subjecting this for filling of juices. And we can clearly see that from this picture. So they were leaving a some head space. So after filling, then they were doing the capping. So in the previous slide, I already discussed you that, okay, for if you are giving a heat treatment, like pasteurization if you do, then the packaging will be a glass bottle with cork cover. Okay, so if you are doing a, if you are adding a chemical as a preservative, then we are using a PET bottles with filter proof caps. So this is the main difference, because we already discussed in the bottle pasteurization. Okay, so bottle pasteurization will be carried out only for glass bottles. See how they were leaving the head space. So it's all continuous process. So see, it can clearly see there is no recontamination here. So this we can clearly see that how they were doing a capping. So this is some of the significant steps in the fruit juices production. Usually in straining, filtration and clarification. So these are the significant processes.
So if you're not clarifying the juices or filtering them properly, okay, it may impart cloudy appearance. And in case of disintegration, like prior to juice extraction, if you're not slice or chopping, if you didn't do it, then the extraction of juice were not sufficient. So then outbreak process, usually this will be carried out for highly heat sensitive vitamins, okay. Usually heartbreak process will be carried out. Next for is MASH enzyme treatment. If the juice is looking cloudy in appearance, then we have to give an enzyme treatment. Okay, usually I already discussed like pectinase, and the role of enzyme is also to increase the heal and also production. And next one is fruit juice extraction process. In this process, care has to be taken. So don't expose the fresh fruits for a prolonged period, okay. So that in the final product, the browning of juices will occur. The next one is deaeration. So care has to be taken. So in the filling of like orange juices, okay, if foam of any oxygen get entered, okay, so it may cause oxidation of ascorbic acid. So these are all the significant steps where we have to take care. So next one is the role of enzymes in juice extraction. So usually the enzymes not only added as a clouding agent or as a filing agent, okay, the enzyme will also helps to increase the healing and also the production, okay. So usually the application of enzymes will be varied on the type of fruits which we are used for the preparation of fruit juices. Okay, for example, the pectinase is an enzyme. Okay, usually in apple pectin-rich products, usually we are added this because the pectin imparts cloudiness in the fruit juices. So the application of pectinase, after adding this, it makes the pectin free in the juices, so that it freely get suspended in the bottle. Okay, after this they were subjecting for clarification process. So the next enzyme is starch and arabinase. So this amylase and arabinase, so the presence of starch and arabs in the juice imparts haziness. So in order to remove this haziness, usually the amylase and arabinase were added. So the next one is naringenases and limonase. So this will be applicable in the preparation of orange fruit juices. So the naringenases and limonases will be added in order to hydrolyze the naringenin and limonin in the grapefruit. Otherwise it may impart the bitterness in the fruit juices. So the next enzyme is cellulase. So usually cellulase will be used for non-pectin substances. So sometimes the non-pectin substances also imparts cloudiness in the fruit juices. So in order to remove this, the cellulase will be added. And sometimes during the extraction of juice or prior to juice extraction, we are subjecting that for pulping, chopping, okay. And if you are exposing the fruit for prolonged period, okay, so what will happen? The browning reaction will start, okay, and after that in the final product the juice may turn into browning color, okay. So next, when you're filling a orange juice into a bottles, care has to taken. So if oxygen, atmosphere oxygen or formation occur in orange juice, okay, so this may cause oxidation of ascorbic acid, and also sometimes the color also might get degraded. So care has to be taken during the filling of orange juices. The next one is bitterness of juices. Okay, if you have not properly treated the juices, usually the orange juices, okay, with naringenases and limonases enzymes, then it will easily impart the bitterness to the juices. So the next problem is cloudy juices. So the cloudy juices is due to pectinase, okay, and some of the suspended solid is due to because of protein, starch and fibers. This all makes juice looks cloudy in appearance. So these are all general problems which occurred in during the preparation of juice processing. So let us watch a video on manufacturing process of juice, what exactly doing in industry. So this is the area where they were receiving a raw material. Usually they were receiving the mangoes from the suppliers. So after receiving, they were keeping in a crates. Then the received raw material was subjected for washing. Usually warm water will be more preferable in order to remove the waxes, or in mangoes usually to remove the laxative, to remove the latex. And again after first washing is completed, then again it is subjected for one more washing. So after cleaning and washing, again they were subjected to this for sorting purpose. Then after sorting, the sorted fruit were, see how they are picked out the unqualified fruits, means the fruit which is shown any damage or injuries, they were removing. So then they were subjecting this for pulping. So in pulping, usually in the mango especially, during the pulping process, it's remove the stones and also it separates the skin. And after that, the pulp was subjected for pulping. See, this is. Then the extracted juice is subjected for heat treatment. So heat treatment is also a method of preserving a fruit juices. Again, after heat treatment, again they are transferred that into another container. So this is all. Then they were doing a sterilization process. Then they were packing in a usually this we call as single strand juice, means this they are not at all adding any water, okay, directly they were extracting the juice from the fruits, okay. So then this product, concentrated product, they were subjected for juice preparation, means it's depending upon the type of juice which manufacturer was manufacturing, like cordial, nectar or ready to serve juices, ready to drink RTS juices, okay. So it's depending upon the type of product where they will do the dilution, okay. They were maintaining some of the total solids and sugar, everything. So here they were aseptically transfer the fruit juices into the container. See in this picture how aseptically they were doing a packing after filling the fruit juices. They were sealing. And they were subjected this for storing. After that they were doing a proper labeling. So that is in whatever in the video we watched, that is in concentrated, means single strength fruit juices. Okay. So usually the manufacturer, he will follow some of the specifications. It's mainly depending upon the type of product which he was manufacturing. Like if you wanted to manufacture squash, if you wanted to prepare crush or fruit syrup or cordial, he has to maintain the total solids contents and fruit juices and also acidity. So why we are coming to the conclusion? So in today's class I am going to conclude. Okay, so why we are carrying out the processing of juice? The first main benefit is we can consume this product throughout the season. Okay, like take it an example, mango. So we can't get this mango throughout the seasons, we can't drink. Okay, so that's why in order to make the product available throughout the season, this processing step will be benefited. And the next important is, so because of this heat treatment, okay, the shelf life got increases because the fruit juices is highly susceptible to spoilage than the whole fruit. The reason behind this is the fruit juices is uncovered by skins or cells, and also the fluid components thoroughly mixed with the hay and also the microorganisms present in the environment. Okay, therefore the untreated juice is more prone to spoilage. So in order to minimize this spoilage, so the processing step is required, and also not only this, the heat treatment is also enhancing the some of the parameter in the fruit juices. And because of this heat treatment which we are giving into the fruit juices, it also reduces the football illness. So these are all the benefits we will get if you are processing a juice. I hope the concept of manufacturing processing of juice based beverages was clear to all of you. Thank you, have a nice day.